Fnatic, the original fan favorite. They will take down Origin.
We don't care about like winning trick. If we play without overconfidence, then for sure we are gonna win.
They're just really good. No, dude, don't say that.
It's not just about being like better players, it's just like being in the right mindset in the right moment.
But like, you don't get like that nervous because it's like OG, the past Fnatic members.
I think they're a pretty strong team, but they cannot face over versus us.
They're for sure the strongest team right now, but they're not unbeatable.
Some graffiti wall, H2K talking some strats before the first game with probably, of course, their mentor and coach telling them what to do in that game. It'll be the first game of the day. There's Pyra and the Fisho helping him out with his tie. Got to make sure those casters look fly to get on the casting desk here today. A little dance there as well. And Rocket concentrated, getting ready on stage, making sure they don't make those mistakes they made yesterday and get a victory here. I'm Efir Shogzaporzera, and with me are James Stress O'Leary, Mitch Krepo Voorspoels, and Trevor Quickshot Henry. We're all ready for a very interesting day here at the European LCS. Let's start by taking a look at the standings, because there are five games left to play for each team here in the regular split. Of course, Fnatic still undefeated in that, historic winning streak, 13-0 Origin and H2K in second, and Gambit Giants and the Unicorns of Love tied, and Elements and Rocket still in playoff contention. I do want to talk about Fnatic Somoto. It's starting to sound like a broken record, but they absolutely deserve it. Yesterday versus H2K, it looked like they were out, honestly.
Yeah, in their game against H2K, they actually got behind pretty far level one due to that poor invade that's on your screen right now. And then eventually later in the top lane, they made a bold move to come back, and then H2K punished that as well. But even then, even with all those advantages for H2K, their poor draft matched up against Fnatic's just impressive shot calling in the mid game, and especially around the Baron. Baron control was fundamental for Fnatic winning this match. And that got them to 13-0. They're now tying Cloud9 in that record, 13-0 for the regular season win streak. Some people are like, hey, but Cloud9, they won 18 games in a row. Yes, but that's 5 games in playoffs, so we're not really counting those just yet. Fnatic could, you know, smash that win streak and the playoff one all together, because they're looking strong. They just have one game remaining here against against Origin today, and if they win that, not only do they confirm that they're the best team in European LCS, they actually lock in that first place, because they're 2-0 against OG, then 2-0 against H2K, and nobody else is even close to touch them.
No, somebody who's very far away, though, and also needs a win is Copenhagen Wolves, or SK, down at the bottom of the table. The fact that that is the final game of today is actually incredibly important for both teams. Yeah. Copenhagen Wolves beat SK the last time they played, which means they own the current head-to-head. And whoever places in 10th is automatically relegated. They are out of the LCS. They're into the challenger scene. So it's very important for both of these squads, who have historically been with the LCS since its inauguration 3 years ago. And I've definitely got my eyes on that game.
Such an important matchup to close out our 2 days here. And well, aside from that, we're also keeping our eyes on a couple of milestones that a couple of our old schoolers here in the league have well done.
Yeah, record-breaking week perhaps here in the LCS. Some legends in the mid lane for the European LCS. XPeke and Froggen both cracked the 600 kill mark for their career kills here in the LCS. XPeke did it in 18 less games, though, and still has one more kill than Froggen, so maybe we'll see that change. But the most important thing to kind of look at here is they've actually got 100 more kills in roughly the same amount of games over the next best, which is Candy Panda sat in that third spot.
Also quite impressive, 430 there for Reckless, only 86 games. Impressive board overall. But while Day One had some big milestones, it also had its share of big plays. From @Cronaya tweeted, "Now that was a wombo combo, a massive cow and a fat man smash into three people into a Yasuo ult. GG SK. Here's your LCS big play of the
mistake
day.
For him. Diamond though, he's gonna go in for the gang and all.
Oh, three man!
Set up!
The
last breath! Gambit, that was incredible.
Still don't know what to say.
I still haven't picked my jaw up off the floor. It was an exquisite play. It was well executed, well planned, and it continued throughout the whole game. High five, Gambit.
It does kind of sound like a joke when it starts, though. A fat man, a cow, and a cowboy walk into mid lane. Like, yeah.
What kind of combination is here on the desk? We don't know. Oh. Now, maybe. Well, remember, you can always nominate your own top-tier play by tweeting at LL Esports and using the hashtag LCSBigPlay. Now, speaking of Twitter, log on today and tell us what have you learned from the teams of the European LCS so far this split, guys?
Don't FF at 20. So for the people out there that are playing their solo queue game, when a game looks like it's lost, you know, when it's thrown, when there's nothing you can do, don't FFF. Don't FF, actually, two FFs only, but like, Fnatic should have lost that game. SK should have probably won like four games so far in a split, but, you know, throws happen.
Rocket should have won.
You can always come back in the game, so kids don't surrender. It's really important.
Yeah, listen to Krepo. Now remember to send your responses, though, at LL Esports and use the hashtag LCS so we can talk over them later today. But first, we have some games to play. We're going to start off with Rocket versus H2K. Later on, the UOL will face Elements, and our game of the week is game four between number one Fnatic and second place Origin. Let's see if OG can do something versus that oh-so-dominant Fnatic. But first, we're going to get down to business and dial in on our very first match of the day between Rocket and H2K. Starting off, a look at Rocket fighting for a seat at the summer playoffs, and we mentioned it already yesterday, they held a 1.8k gold lead, and actually in their last eight games where they've held a gold lead at 20 minutes, they've lost five of those games. How come those problems are still persisting?
As a team, Rocket are just not resolving their shot calling issues. We continually see them do average to, you know, good in the early game, but every time they build up a lead, it just stagnates and falls apart. Rocket do not push their advantages and don't really play the map out very well. I also think when you look at the players, individually they have moments that are great, but they're not consistent enough across the entire team to actually carry them through to a lot of these victories.
Yeah, something we have been looking or keeping an eye on is Nukeduck in that mid lane forever, that prodigy, and it never really came out. It came out for three games on Varus, but the difference with the other champions has been too big.
It's been a massive difference. I mean, you look at their wins, he's seemed maybe almost irrelevant off of the Varus. I don't think it's quite that far, but you know, it certainly is a lot to be said. But you take a look at his stats without Varus, they don't really tell the tale of too much defeat, but certainly they don't live up to how Rocket have been playing when the Varus has been there.
Yeah, with the Varus, he's been looking fantastic. And while his stats look all right on first glance, we do have the recollection in our minds of some of those Azir ultimates, for example, yeah, that just didn't quite connect. And Nukeduck, he's close, but he can't just get that mark on the game. And whereas he's a fantastic mechanical player, because many times in the season has he had the rank one in solo queue, so he can definitely play the game when he's in his comfort zone, but just hasn't found another comfort pick really to excel. He can match other players, but he needs to excel and transcend that. And that has been the Varus for him to an extent, but not quite another pick just yet.
And very quickly, Rocket have the second longest average game time in the European LCS. They push games late, whether they're winning or losing, but they're not particularly good or adept in the late game. So this is something that as a team, Yamato needs to get his team to resolve if they want to continue picking up wins looking towards playoffs.
Yeah, well, tough game here for them as they're up against H2K, currently in third place. Yesterday versus Fnatic, though, they had an enormous lead, the biggest lead a team has held versus Fnatic in the summer, 1.7k by the 10-minute mark and 4.7k by the 20-minute mark. We all remember what happened. You talked about it, Krepo, and that invade. Everything going so well. So where did it go awry?
So what I liked about H2K's approach to that match was that they realized they couldn't target ban on Huni, for example, so you shouldn't really try that anymore. So they tried to pinch Rain over his pool, put him into a uncomfortable position, because he's kind of the feeding system. Right? He delivers everything towards Huni, towards Feverman in the mid lane, and then tries to set that up. They got ahead, whether what due to draft or not, but they got ahead early game, but then they had some weaknesses in their draft later on. They, you know, lacked some sieging, they couldn't really close out, and then they made some poor mistakes. And then they match up against a team that is so good in shot calling and Baron control, like Fnatic. The H2K of yore was so good at closing out games. They were this macro-level strategic team that was so good at closing and controlling the map, and we've seen that less and less the last few weeks.
Well, yeah, I kind of want to keep it on the draft for just a second, because there were more issues than I think than even that. And that was the AD carry pick. Yes, there was Kalista and Sivir and Corki not available, but they then defaulted to Lucian, who 0-11 now in the LCS for Lucian. And you can see it reflected in Hyannon's damage stats. In that game from yesterday, 361 damage per minute. That's his second lowest damage this split when you look at it. And compare it to his average, 614 damage per minute on average, just above half of what he'd normally do. I think there were other optimal picks that they could have picked up. I mean, they've played the Jinx before. We were talking beforehand. Tristana maybe even would have been a pick if they wanted to go for it, but Lucian was what they went on, and it just did not impress.
Yeah, well, we'll see what lessons H2K learned out of that game. The stage is set, so let's kick it over to our casters and load on to the Rift.
Thank you very much, Shox.